Hello and welcome to part number 13 of Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom No Death playthrough. Last part we completed the first of the four great fairies. We unlocked the first one and today we're going to be doing the same for the second one. And it involves the same, more of the same. We have to speak to the stable trotter and we need to get the fetch quest for the great fairy. He's going to point us where the fairy is and then where to get it. Now, in between part number 12 and 13, I did do the errand of unlocking the shrines near to here and to other great fairies. So I'm not going to have the opportunity to show that, but that's fine. It's more of the same. The locations are as follows. So I unlocked this shrine by going to the sky tower here, or sorry, the sky island here. And then I unlocked this shrine close to this fairy fountain by going to the sky tower, sky island here. I keep quitting. And then finally I unlocked this one, this shrine, by going to the sky tower here. So fairly straightforward. Now he's given us a quest. The quest is as follows. We have to do a serenade to Kaysa, and we need to find one of the stable trotter members. This person's name is Piper, and they are in a stable in Farron region, so that is where we'll go. We actually have a really nice handy dandy quest objective here, which gives us exactly where we can find this guy. Now it is a bit far, as you can see. The closest would be the sky tower, and so we're going to be taking this and gliding our way on over to that location. Piper is the second of the five members. There's the head, then there's the violinist. This guy plays the flute or the lute, however you want to call it. And then we've got the person who plays the drum, and I don't know what the last instrument is called. It's the bigger flute, I think. I don't know what you call it. Forgive my lack of knowledge when it comes to musical instruments. That is the Great Dragonhead Islands. It's always covered in a thunderstorm, so we can't really do much about it. And as we glide closer, I notice that we are actually going to be riding way too fast to that location, so may as well glide. That should be the shrine we're supposed to reach. Runabouts there. It's a Farron region. And it's near a stable. So yeah, that should be it. May have to do some hustle there. But yeah, this is more a routine, so I'm just going to resume once I'm there. And we've nearly arrived at our destination. I will unlock this shrine in case I need to fast travel here. Oh, and we've got the electric choo-choo. I didn't think they would be in this area, especially the electric ones. Typically you just find the regular versions of those, but I guess in Tears of the Kingdom they have made some changes to this. Wonder if any of these trees are alive and want to attack me. So here is where we'll hear rumors of the guy. We'll speak to this person here. I think this one. Nope. We need to speak to someone, sorry. I suppose not. At any case, this is the place where this person's found. I thought you had to speak to that person, but I guess not. Whoa. Okay, lovely. So this is the guy, or girl, or whatever. Stable Trotter, yes I am. And they want you back, but he also wants you to do something for him, which is to fetch these fireflies. And 10 of these is what we need. I'm curious to know is if this guy, Beetle, sells any of these. Yeah, sunset fireflies, you can get 3 of these. So this is a good way of getting them. You just need 10. Let's see, do I have anything to sell? Not particularly, I kind of need all of this stuff. Yeah. Okay, so what time is it? It is PM. We'll need to rest because the issue here is that we'll need to find these fireflies at nighttime and they won't spawn here. So what I'm going to do is actually just demonstrate the use of a stable and what this can do. I'll give you a pony point. Okay. Nope. I guess I'll have to go inside to speak to the guy. Let's get the reward first. Oops. Okay, what is this? What is he seeing? Oh. If you save just 3 more points, you're able to register 1 additional horse. Okay. So you can only register 1 horse at a time. Okay, that's fine. So you could sleep here for 20 rupees or 50. 50 rupees will give you additional hearts. So I'm going to do that. And wake me up at nighttime, 9 p.m. So that I can actually get the sunset fireflies to spawn. Again, I'm not going to be able to get all of them. So I wonder if I can get 7. If I can't get 7, I'll just go buy them from Beetle, but that would require waiting at a separate location, in which case I'll fast travel back to Lookout Landing, sleep, come back, and his shop will reset. I'm hoping to find at least 4. And there you go. So that's the benefit of doing that. So for 50 additional rupees, you can get that. Plus, you can get an additional Semna wheel, as you saw there. So that's the benefit of that. Oh, the stamina wheel. I think you would get the stamina wheel from that. Okay, interesting. This changes everything, actually. I've been looking for additional stamina or replenishing food this whole run, and now here we are. Okay, perfect. Something to note for in the future. But to be honest, rupees are kind of important. And at that point in the game, I didn't have all that many. Although 50 rupees, it's a bargain. For an additional stamina wheel, you can just go that much farther. Okay, so that's perfect. Here are some fireflies for us, which we'll attempt to get. It's 1. That is, oh gosh. That is 2. No. Oh, I see one more. Oh, that's just the after effect. Never mind. Okay, there's some trees here. You can typically find them near trees. Already kind of used up my stamina. May as well. I don't have any pressing need for it. I have honestly learned something new. I did not think that the Melania bed would give you an additional stamina wheel. That's a huge thing. For 50 additional rupees, you can just go that much further. Having said that, you still need the stamina replenishing food because it's only 1 stamina wheel. But still, I mean, stamina wheel at the start of the game, at that point, it's pretty amazing. Okay, enough dilly-dallying. Where exactly is this? Me as well. And Blood Moon's about to happen. Okay, interesting. Might as well let it play out. No Sunset Fireflies though. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna wait for the RNG. I'm going to go to Sky Lookout Landing and then just wait and then buy it from Beetle.
When the glow of the blood-stained moon shines.
And that process is fairly straightforward. I'm not going to show it. It's fairly routine. Essentially, just go to Lookout Landing right here. Sleep in the bed till morning. Come back to this shrine here. Buy the items from Beetle because his shop will reset. And then do it one more time and you'll get your 10 fireflies. So I'm going to pause and then come back. Thank you. And we're back after two trips to the Lookout Landing Skyview Tower. Now, in case there are questions in relation to why not sleep here in the stable, there are beds here. It's only 20 rupees. The reason for that is that I've noticed is that the shopkeeper inventory does not restock if I do not sleep in a different location, which is far from this location. So that's kind of my observation. And so we've got what we need, and that's 10 of these. And then what you're gonna do is speak to the guy right here. And you can give him the fireflies. At this point, you need to find this girl who is looking to... She should be running around here somewhere. Okay, hold on. Let me just check the adventure log here. This one. So you need to bring this girl named Haley to the tree at night. Now if I can find Haley, that'd be great. Is this her? That's her. Oh, you're Hayati, sorry. Okay, so at this point we'll just sleep here, I guess. And so we speak to this guy, pay 20 more rupees, and we'll get what we need. Or actually, not even that. We don't need to sleep, we just need the time to pass. There should be a fire here, yep. Perfect. Why waste money? Although, in this game, I've noticed that I use rupees less so. Okay, there she is. And then you can you can get her to follow you. This should be the general location. And this was where he created a fire here, trying to impress her. And now we wait. And he will sing the, or sorry, play the flute. And I cannot forward this part. But essentially, this will trigger multiple fireflies to appear, short of the 10 that he had. And this is what he wanted to do with the fire. And then that scatter. And thank you so much. This is one of those, usually like a in-game sort of cutscene. He'll give you a hearty truffle, and then he'll head out to the serenade place. There you go. So it's the great fairy Kaysa we're looking at right now. Oh gosh. That was totally unnecessary. Decided to dive just to show off, I guess. So again, the great fairy is up there, but they want their chariot fixed. Okay, so what we do basically is take this Zonai device. There should be a wheel here. And attach it here. Perfect. And put their card here. Now, how they got here with their card broken and how it breaks every time speaks volumes to these guys' ability to do this properly. Should be a steering shift here as well. There it is. So these sort of devices are actually pretty good. You put a steering shift and you can sort of drive around Hyrule if you so desire. The only limiting factor is your battery consumption, really. That's good enough. And if you bring it closer to these guys, they'll be sure to take it. Yep. Yeah, yeah. And there you go. So your R is supposed to go up this sort of area. They shouldn't get off of it, I don't think. Okay, maybe a little bit. That is horrible. I kind of figured we would be able to do this correctly. Okay, see that? Oh, never mind. They're okay. Okay. That went better than expected. I thought he would just say, okay, well, I'm done here, and send me back, but he actually didn't. Perfect. You could do a bunch of stuff. You could also make this fly, if you so desire. Okay, and we're back. Sorry about that. So, there were some technical issues, and I couldn't record the entire thing. This entire video is a little bit scuffed. Lots of editing needs to be done, a lot of things that got into it that I did not intend to get in, so apologies for that, but We have unlocked the fairy here. And that's Kaysa.
Yeah, yeah.
We get a silver rupee here.
Yeah, yeah.
So, just to see, this glide set, for example, the mask can be upgraded. I'm going to enhance it once. It does cost 10 rupees. Okay, so she's left because she knows that we don't have the gear for it or the materials for it. And so that's what we need basically. We need a lot more Keys Wings and Arakuda Eyeballs. So this set is kind of annoying to upgrade because of that. So there's 9 plus 15. So 24 Keys Wings and 12 Arakuda Eyeballs are needed for this. So that's kind of what we need. And for the Fierce Deity, we need these items at this moment in time. So I'll cover that in a separate video. But for now, just to kind of showcase that we can indeed upgrade this twice. There you have it. And with that, I'll leave it at that. And yeah, continuing on, we will attempt to unlock more of these fairy fountains till we have all four unlocked and ready to go. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye bye.